Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter study of animal tissue. In that we are studying topic epithelial tissue. Now when I say epi, it means above, and when I say thelial, it means that grows above the surface. The tissue that's present on your skin is epithelial tissue. Let's study a little bit more about it. Epithelial tissue. Now, once we come across epithelial tissue, a simple example that I could give you all is the tissue that's present on your skin. It's epithelial tissue. The tissue that does not allow the entry of your lotion, cream, oil, raindrops which fall on your skin, or even water inside your body. That's epithelial tissue. So basically, epithelial tissue in general forms the covering of external as well as internal surfaces of your body. For example, your heart, your stomach, your liver is covered by a thin membrane of epithelial tissue. Yes, it is different kinds of epithelial tissue that are present on this coverings, not the same type. The cells of your epithelial tissue, if you see, are closely packed. And if the cells are closely packed, there will be very little space available in those cells. Also, there is a cementing substance or a cement kind of substance present between them, and that's termed as matrix. The cells basically rely on a basement membrane if you observe this epithelial tissues under a microscope. Now, depending upon epithelial tissues can be divided into three different types on the junctional complexes, and those types are the tight junctional complexes, adhering junctional complexes, and gap junctional complexes. Now, tight junctional complexes, you're correct, it prevents leakage. Anything where tight junctional complexes are present cannot leak. Adhering junctional complexes help in the joining of two different cells, whereas gap junctional complexes of epithelial tissues help in the movement of biomolecules. Epithelial tissue. Now, epithelial tissue is the tissue that is present on your skin. Epi means above and thelial means it's growing above. It forms the covering for external as well as internal surfaces of your body. And when I say internal surfaces, it could be your stomach, your ribcage. Different kinds of epithelial are present on their surfaces. Now, cells in epithelial tissue are basically closely packed. Also, there will be little space available between the cells. And the cementing substance, or you can say a substance that acts as a glue between the cells, is your matrix. The cells basically rest on a basement kind of a membrane. Now, between epithelial cells, what you really observe is there are three types of junctional complexes. And now these three types of junctional complexes are your tight junctions, adhering junctions, and gap junctions. Now, firstly, what are tight junctions? Tight junctions are nothing but layers of epithelial cell which actually prevent leakage of a substance. They don't allow certain molecules that are present inside epithelial cells to ooze out or move out. Adhering junction. Now, when you talk about that word adhering, adhering means something that stick around. Now, adhering junctions are basically with cement or simple language which allow to stick the adjoining cells by a substance made up of carbohydrate derivative. And now this carbohydrate derivative could be a disaccharide or sometimes a polysaccharide depending upon the source of the plant. For example, in some plants, woody plants, it is chitin. In other plants, this could be starch also. And lastly, your gap junctions. Now, if I talk about gap junctions, they allow the movement of ions. And now these ions could be sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, anything of this. And biomolecules between adjoining cells. Now, ions basically would be moving in and out of the cells. For example, sodium and potassium pumps, which are present just around the cell, allow the ions to move depending upon the electric current that's flowing and how the ions are exchanged between the cells. Also, the phospholipid bilayer or the fat layer around the cell also will provide a support to the gap junction whenever there is an exchange between the ion molecules or whenever there is an exchange between the surfaces for ion derivatives. So students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about epithelial tissue. What is the structure, what's the origin, and what are the different types of junctions present in it. I hope you all are very clear about this concept. Thank you.